In this video, we will learn about checkout options. Checkout options are basically an option. Let's say a user added products to his cart, he want to buy it. Then the final option is he need to go to the checkout for payment. At the time of checkout, you can see all the details of the product with the price as well as other options. So now we will see how we can work upon it. To go to the checkout option, log into your website as an admin. Here you can see admin panel visible. You have reached the dashboard section. Here you can see, go to the stores option, left menu, click on it. On clicking here, you can see some settings are visible. Click on configuration. Now you can see the configuration options are visible. Now go to the bottom. Here you can see some tabs are visible. Click on sales tab. After clicking sales, here you can see checkout options are visible. Click on checkout. Now you can see some options are visible. First go to the checkout options. Here you can see if you want to enable one page checkout, you have to go to yes, which is the default. If you want to allow guest checkout, you can easily go here and select yes here. If you want to display billing address on payment method, you can mention it here. If you want it of a payment page, then add payment page. Here you can add it. If you want to enable terms and condition, you just need to select yes here. The other options are for shopping cart checkout options. If you want to add the cart lifetime days, you can easily add it from here. The default here added it 30. If you want that if a user adds a product, it should be redirected to shopping cart. If yes, you should mention yes, but the default is no, so keep as it is. These are for grouped images as well as configurable product images, which were the type of products which we have discussed before. If you want to show the images, which images you want to show, do you want to show the thumbnail image, you can change it. If you want to show other images, just select the option from here. Here you can see, you can select the parent product thumbnail also. So here you can see other options are available. My cart link options are visible. If you want to display the cart summary, you can show it. It will display item quantities here. If you want to change it, for changing it, uncheck it here. If you want to show number of items in cart, you can show it from here by selecting the option here. Here we are using the system value, which is the default. Now moving further, here is the sidebar option. If you want to show the display the shopping cart sidebar, as well as the if the user is searching for a product, do you want to show the shopping cart sidebar? Yes, we want to show it. So yes is enabled. If you want to show the recently added items, top 5 will be visible here. The last option is quite important, payment failed emails. Here you can see, you can set the settings for that, who will receive the payment failed emails. Here you can set the options. If you want to add it to CC, you can add it. If you want to also add copy methods, you can easily add it. Let's say you want a copy of the payment failed emails, you can add the email ID here. As well as if you want it for a separate email, you want to send a separate email, you can send it. Or if you want under BCC, which is blank carbon copy, you can easily mention it here. After doing the changes, here on the left, you can see, click on save configuration. So in this video, we basically learned why checkout options are needed, how we can easily enable it, how we can easily enable guest checkout, as well as how we can enable other options. Thank you for watching.